Typical antipsychotics, also called first-generation antipsychotics, are a class of drugs used to treat psychosis and acute agitation. In this video, I'll teach you my visual mnemonic to remember all the different typical antipsychotic drugs, as well as their clinical uses and side effects. Here we go. It's the middle of the night at the art museum, but not just any night. It's the night before the grand opening of the new Scream painting exhibit. The Scream is a classic painting worth millions of dollars. So this robber has decided to run a heist tonight. By the way, the Scream painting here will be our recurring symbol for psychosis. Just look at how the subject of the painting has lost touch with reality, holding their face as the world twists around them, sort of like someone with psychosis. Let the psychosis projected from this painting remind you that this video is about the medications that treat psychosis, or antipsychotics. Make sense? And we aren't surprised to find this Scream painting in a museum because, well, it's the typical setting for a famous painting. So, this Scream painting, in its typical setting, is our collective symbol for typical antipsychotics. Got that? This is in contrast to our video on atypical antipsychotics. Check that video out next. Next, I want to go over the two most common typical antipsychotics that you'll come across on the NCLEX and in real life. The robber has backed up his getaway vehicle right into the museum's door. The truck's taillights are bright in the dark night, so bright they are forming halos. These halos around the lights are our symbol for the drug haloperidol. Get it? Halo for haloperidol? You can even think of it as haloperidol if it helps. The heist isn't going exactly as planned. A security guard has stumbled upon the thief as he's making a run for the truck with the Scream painting in hand. Knowing the importance of the painting, this guard is calling for backup using his flip phone. Coincidentally, the flip phone here is our symbol for the drug fluphenazine. It's the fluphenazine flip phone, or fluphenazine. Get it? Now that we've gotten the major drug names out of the way, let's spend some time talking about where typical antipsychotics are used in the clinical setting. We're bringing it back to the Scream painting for a minute. Hopefully by now you understand that the Scream painting is our symbol for psychosis. It makes sense that antipsychotics treat psychosis, right? So what is psychosis anyway? To put it simply, it's when a patient has lost touch with reality, thought to arise from excess dopamine levels in the brain. You see, the archetypal psychotic disorder is schizophrenia. A while back, typical antipsychotics were often prescribed to patients diagnosed with schizophrenia, and they are still used for schizophrenia today. Just not as a first-line treatment, because they have so many side effects. And, in addition, these drugs only target the positive symptoms of schizophrenia. This means that they treat things like hallucinations and delusions, while having minimal to no effect on the negative symptoms, which are things like flat affect or antisocial behavior. This is why the newer atypical antipsychotics are preferred. We're going to cover the atypical antipsychotics in a different video, but for now, just remember that typical antipsychotics may be used to treat psychosis and schizophrenia if other forms of treatment have failed. As you can imagine, the security guard is super agitated. How dare someone try to steal this valuable painting on his watch? The security guard is determined to catch up to the robber and take him down. Use this agitated and aggressive security guard to remind you that typical antipsychotics can be given to treat acute agitation and aggression. Patients who are delirious under the influence of drugs or who are preoccupied with delusional thoughts may become dangerously agitated, which means that they could become abusive or violent, becoming a danger to nurses, patients, and other healthcare workers in the hospital, not to mention themselves. Haloperidol is commonly given intramuscularly when a patient is putting his or herself or others in danger. Remember that this is considered a pharmacological restraint and should only be used as a last resort option when other methods of calming down a patient have failed. As a disguise, the robber dressed himself up as an EPS delivery driver. Pretty good idea, but one oversight was choosing such a noisy and bright getaway car. Yep, that old and rickety EPS truck is rattling up a storm. That's what gave the robber away to the security guard. This EPS truck is our symbol for the extrapyramidal symptoms, commonly abbreviated EPS. To put it simply, EPS is a drug-induced disorder that affects the body's movement. So, just like this EPS truck is rattling, patients experiencing EPS may develop shaky tremors, muscle spasms, stiffness, restlessness, and uncontrollable actions, like lip smacking or sticking out the tongue. Each of these movements actually has a scientific name. Perhaps you've heard of dystonia, pseudo-Parkinsonism, akathisia, or tardive dyskinesia. These are good terms to be familiar with, and although we won't discuss them in detail here, just remember that EPS refers to a collection of all of these movement problems, especially the tremors that resemble this rattling truck. EPS is a common and expected side effect with typical antipsychotics, but it should still be reported to the physician, who may recommend a change in the prescription. In his anger and aggression, the security guard grabbed the first weapon he could find. He happened to be walking by a modern art exhibit of graffiti painted on a wall with lead pipes. Hey, anything can be art these days. This particular wall has graffitied the letters NMS on it, which should remind you of NMS. You know, NMS, short for neuroleptic malignant syndrome. NMS is an important side effect for you to know because it is a medical emergency. It has a few classic characteristics, one of them being muscle rigidity, which is also known as lead pipe rigidity, because the person is as stiff as a lead pipe. Hence, the lead pipe here in our scene, get it? Other symptoms of NMS are fever, altered mental status, and unstable vital signs. Yeah, you don't want to wait with this one. If NMS is seen, all antipsychotics should be held and the provider should be notified immediately. Want me to run through those symptoms one more time? Lead pipe muscle rigidity, fever, confusion, and unstable vitals make up neuroleptic malignant syndrome. If a patient taking an antipsychotic has these symptoms, act fast. Where's the backup? They should be here by now. I see one security guard there slumped on the floor, fast asleep. I guess it's tough staying awake through the night shift after all, especially when nothing happens most of the time. By the way, this sleeping or sedated security guard is the symbol for sedation. Typical antipsychotics tend to make people drowsy. This is an expected side effect of the drug, which, recall, is used to calm agitated or aggressive people down. Therefore, people taking typical antipsychotics should avoid taking substances that also cause drowsiness, like benzodiazepines and alcohol, to prevent over-sedation. This poor, sleepy security guard tried really hard to stay awake. He's really tired. Take a look at the empty bottles of cola on the ground next to him. He was drinking cola, a sugary caffeinated beverage, to try to stay awake, but to no avail. Hey, the thief is slipping on the empty bottle. Maybe this will slow him down enough for the other security guards to catch up. Here at Pixorize, we use empty cola bottles as our symbol for anticholinergic effects. Get it? Anticholinergics? Because acetylcholine, or acetylcola signaling, is decreased, kind of like how the levels of cola here are pretty low in these empty bottles. Anticholinergic effects include a constellation of symptoms like dry mouth, blurry vision, urinary retention, constipation, tachycardia, and more. I don't recommend memorizing this laundry list. Instead, I like to think of this as inhibition of the rest and digest system, or the parasympathetic system, of our body. Of course, this will cause constipation, urinary retention, and increased heart rate. Make sense? One final symbol here before we wrap up. I mentioned earlier that this is the Scream exhibit's grand opening. Like you would expect, the museum has been decorated for this debut. Take a look at the twisted streamers here hanging from the ceiling. You know, the way the streamers are twisted like that reminds me of a cardiac rhythm called torsade de pointe. You know, since torsade literally looks like a twisted streamer pattern on an EKG or heart rhythm strip. Torsade de pointe is a deadly arrhythmia and will usually start as a prolonged QT interval. Typical antipsychotics are known to prolong the QT interval, increasing the person's chance of converting to the dangerous torsade de pointe rhythm. keep a close eye on the patient's cardiac monitoring to watch out for this side effect. All right, that's it for the typical antipsychotics, but really quick, let's review everything we've learned here. Typical antipsychotics are a class of drugs that include haloperidol and fluphenazine. As their name suggests, the typical antipsychotics are used to treat psychosis and psychotic disorders like schizophrenia, as well as dangerous agitation and aggression. Side effects include extrapyramidal symptoms, abbreviated EPS, neuroleptic malignant syndrome, abbreviated NMS, drowsiness or sedation, anticholinergic effects, and a prolonged QT interval that puts the patient at risk for torsade de pointe. And that's it for the typical antipsychotics. I'm not sure if the art heist is going to be successful or not, but I'm not going to stay around to find out. I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching. For more videos like this one, subscribe to our channel and check out our newest lessons. For more resources on this topic, including fact lists and interactive review images, click the image next to the More Here arrow. I'll see you next time.